How systems of equations can be used to solve word problems. This video focuses on how you can solve some word problems by defining two variables and writing two equations to comprise a system of equations. I then suggest the person watching the video pause it and solve the system using either the substitution or addition method. So that method is covered in other videos. So the steps used to solve the system are not shown on this video. I do provide the values you should get for each variable after you solve it, and I write the answer to the word problem and show you how to check your answer. So the focus of this video is on how to set up a system of equations and how to check the answer. And usually you can do this when you're looking for two things. That's sort of the key, that you can define two variables and set up a system. Okay. Once you know how to solve a system of equations, you can then use system of equations to solve certain word problems. And this usually is where you're looking for two things as opposed to one thing. So for instance, you might be looking for the width and the length of a rectangle as opposed to just the width. So here's an example. Two CDs and four DVDs cost $40. Three CDs and five DVDs cost $55. Find the cost of each. Now here's an example where we're trying to find two things, the cost of a CD and the cost of a DVD. So the first thing you want to do is introduce a variable for each thing you're looking for. So that's called defining your variables. So the cost of a CD, we can call it X, or I'm going to let it be called C. And the reason is, in the end of the problem, that'll remind me, C is the cost of the CD. And the cost of a DVD, I'll let that be called D. So what do we have? Let's look back at the sentence. Two CDs and four DVDs cost $40. All right. If each CD costs C dollars, two of them will cost 2C. But you want to add that to the cost of four DVDs. Each DVD is D, so that's 4D. That's how much all the DVDs cost. And altogether, it says that costs $40. What else does it say? Three CDs and five DVDs cost $55. So three CDs, each one costing C, that'll be 3C. Plus, add that to the cost of five DVDs, 5D, that would be $55. And there's your system right here. Now, you can use this system using substitution, or you can use the addition method. You could graph it. That would be pretty difficult in this case. So usually, substitution or addition would be preferred. Now, take a quick note at this first equation, 2C plus 4D equals 40. Notice that there's a common factor of 2. You could make that a little bit easier equation by just dividing everything by 2. That's up to you. If you do that, then you get the equation C plus 2D equals 20. Again, up to you. What I want you to do is take those two equations, take that system, and solve it. Put it on pause and use the substitution or the addition method, and then figure out what the cost of the CD and the cost of the DVD is. Okay, so I'm going to assume you did that and you're back. And I'm not going to show the work. You could use any method you want, but you should have gotten that C was $10. Remember, we were talking money, so it's $10 for a CD. And you should have got that D was $5. Actually, you would have just got C is 10, right? And D is 5. That's really what happened. But then you have to remember what that stands for. So you would say CD costs $10, DVD costs $5. Now, usually, don't DVDs cost more? But in this particular example, it looks like it was the other way around. So let's check and see if this made sense. Now we're going to use our common sense only. You're not going to go back to an equation. because you are the one who wrote the equation, and if you wrote the wrong equation and you check it in that, you're really not checking it against the original words that were given to you. It says two CDs and four DVDs cost $40. All right, so let's see. If this were the cost of a CD, $10, two CDs would cost how much? $20. And four DVDs, if you also bought four DVDs, all right, $5 each. Four at $5 would also be $20. So that would add up to $40. So that part is true. That first sentence is still correct. All right, let's also check the second part. It says three CDs and five DVDs cost $55. So three CDs, what would that be? Well, $10 each, that'd be $30. And also five DVDs, all right, $5 each, that would be $25. That adds up to $55. So you know what? Our solution of a CD costing $10 and a DVD costing $5 does meet the original criteria. So you have to look back up to the problem. So what I'm focusing on is writing the variables, in other words, defining your variables. And you could always let one be X and the other be Y, that's fine, or any letter you want. And then you're going to write two equations. So usually there'll be a couple sentences at least where you'll be able to write two equations from the information given. Solve it using any method you want. That is not what I'm showing right now, but you can use substitution or the addition method. Then we have to answer the original question, which was find the cost of each. So the CD cost $10, DVD cost $5. And then we want to check that that solution makes sense in the original word problem. Okay, let's go on to a different problem. Okay, this is more of a puzzle problem. The sum of two numbers is 76 and their difference is 52. Find the two numbers. Okay, what are we looking for? We're looking for two different numbers. So our first thing is to represent two numbers, okay? So we're just going to put the first number. Let's call that X, and then we'll call the second number Y. It really doesn't matter, what variables you use. All right, so we've got two things it tells us. The sum of the two numbers is 76, okay? Well, that means add them up. It says the difference is 52. So there's our system. X minus Y equals 52. Now this one lends itself very easily to the addition method. Do you see how if you add the Y value, the Y's cancel out? So you should be able to get your answer pretty quickly. So quickly solve this. And then see if it's true that the answers you get, the sum of the two numbers you get ends up being 56 and their difference is 52. Put it on pause, do that, then come back. Okay, the solutions. Solution, the numbers are 64 and 12. And you could easily check that when you add those numbers, you get 76, and when you subtract those numbers, you do get 52. So that's the answer to our problem, or you could just say 64 and 12.